to my channel. Hey yo, hey yo, listen up, listen up,
in charge of the girls, right?
I am in charge of the girls.
Are you in charge of the girls?
I am in charge of the girls.
Okay.
All right. Welcome back to all of my returning Wi-Fis and welcome in to my brand new viewers. Go ahead and do me a favor on your way in and like this video. Why? Because when you like it, well, I love it. And if you haven't already, make sure that you subscribe to this channel. And that you click the notification bell for notifications of when I upload new content and when I go live. You want to be there for that when it happens. And you can't without a notification. So go ahead and click that bell. Tonight on this very late night transmission of The Wireless Woman, we are going to be talking all about wifing. So you think you can wife, huh? Huh? I am a two-time all-star wife extraordinaire. And therefore, even though I won't consider myself like an expert in wifing because I didn't have particularly long marriages, I do think if your goal is to get married, well, I've done that not once, but twice, and more than likely will do it thrice. That's not a flex. That's not a brag, but I say it because a lot of women, I think, approach relationships with the goal of being a wife, but you are in a relationship with a person who may not have had the same goal as you. And I know this is a bit of a side note, okay, a lot of a side note, but the counterproductive goals of men and women in relationships don't change regardless of the stage of that relationship. That's why agreement is so important, because you will find yourself throughout the life of your relationship with another person. Not that it's men per se that are causing this problem, but because I'm a woman and can only speak for being in relationship with men. You know, men be like, well, what about when I'm not a man. That's why y'all got these microphones as well. And you can say your side and speak your speech. But over here,
the black woman is the first manifestation of God on earth.
I'm going to speak as a woman for women, to women, for us, by us. I would love to consider the perspectives of men, which is why I invite them on to my channel, for them to share theirs, for us to seek truth together. However, I don't wake up with men's thoughts on my mind. If I did, that to me would be more masculine than just saying what women really think. But here in the Twilight Zone,
you've just crossed over into the Twilight Zone.
Here on these episodes of Black Mirror, here in the Truman Show that we operate in every day, well, damn, that's what you expected to do. You're expected to be a mind-reading woman who is able to transmute the thoughts of men when you're speaking. But I'm not speaking on y'all's behalf, so anyway. But you will find, because of the hormonal changes and imbalances between men and women, even as men get older, they become more and more and more and more and more and more passive and submissive and docile. So women, as our estrogen begins to taper off in our older ages, will become more assertive, will become more you know, forward pushing and thinking and how we are, because the testosterone for us builds later in life where it is for a man earlier in life. So the path of marriage is always going to be converging and diverging in certain places, where men are bringing certain things to the relationship and women are bringing other things to the relationship. But if people don't have a clear understanding of what the goal of marriage is, because the goal of the relationship is to get married. But once you get married, that's no longer the goal of the relationship. So a lot of people get into marriages with no goal, no purpose for what the marriage is actually supposed to produce for them in their lives other than happiness. So then when they don't have the happiness in the marriage that they thought the relationship promised them, it's like, okay, I'm a head out. So we have seen over the past several weeks and months, cheating scandals after scandal after scandal. It's like an episode of Scandal, to be quite honest, at this point. And a lot of that is because of men and women, but mostly men, being inside of marriages and having lost track of what the end goal of marriage is, which is for one of us to die. Until one of us dies, we just get up each day and we do this until one of us dies.
Until one of us dies.
You know, and the hope, not the goal, but the hope is that you don't have to spend each day miserable waiting on one of us to die. Hoping that one of us dies. That is not the hope. The hope is that you will spend each day making the initial decision more and more worthwhile. So the reason why I came into this particular episode to say anything at all about wifing, because as I said, a lot of people think that I'm anti-males and hate men and super masculine, but I've been engaged. Well, I've been proposed to several times. I've only been engaged a few times and then married two times. So there was a selection process there. You know, people will tell you to choose better as if I chose wrong, not once, but twice. But you choose based on who you are and where you are in those seasons. The choice has nothing to do with the performance. It has nothing to do with the commitment. It's like if you buy a house, I'm buying a house, or if you buy a car, newer models of cars will come along that have features that were not available to you at the time that you bought that car. You know, the iPhone 52 is going to come out, and let's be honest, really just be nothing but the iPhone 12. However, whatever new feature, which is probably something that they're going to take away and not actually add to the phone, is going to be the reason you go out and get the next thing, is whatever that new feature is. It's essentially, or you're hoping essentially, it's the same exact phone. You just want this one or two features. And when most people are very unhappy in their marriages, it's only because of one or two things. So I chose correctly. The problem comes in with the performance of the commitment after said choice is made. That's the place where people get to go back in hindsight and say, oh, boop, boop. Well, you chose with the information you had at the time. You chose with the options you had available to you at the time. I want a moonroof now. But I didn't have moonroof money back then when I was buying it, Derek Jackson, you know, and that is the case of what people call the come up woman. People get the woman that they can afford, that they can compliment at that time. And then if she glows up or if he glows up, because usually a man's glow up is his woman, let's just be honest. We get with these dudes and start showing them how, you know, how to wear their clothes right and all kinds of stuff. Just even though we don't get credited for that, we have to remember what the initial commitment was based on. I don't feel like the car I have 5 years later is worth the car payment that I paid for it on the first day. But it's not about whether or not the intrinsic value of the vehicle increased or decreased. It's about the fact that I made a commitment on day one when I wanted that car to make this payment. So like, yeah, it's a total bucket now, but I made a commitment 5 years ago to pay for it and to keep it and to complete those payments. You know, we can always trade out when it comes to a car, you know, just trade up into something else. But when you trade out, you lose so much of the value of what you put into the car just to buy back into something that is an extension of the same commitment you made. Most people, when they go into a new relationship, are starting over, building those tenets and components of loyalty and fidelity and faithfulness. And who really wants to take what they've invested and just go out, throw it out, start over? We can name several people, but I'm down in a hole that I'm going to come up out of right now and tell you what brought me here today, which was I was watching a YouTube video, but I'm pretty sure it was a TikTok. I just be watching TikToks on YouTube, and I really need to cut out the middleman on that and just go ahead and watch TikToks. But TikTok, I don't know, it's draining to me. I don't know how y'all feel about it, but like it just like it goes by itself. It's just, it's like a hamster on a wheel. It's a little too much for my aging geriatric millennial mind. You know, we had Mario, Oregon Trail. This is a bit much. That's why, and that's another side note, I really think that a lot of this technology has to be alien technology because we came too far, too fucking far in like 25 years. I just, okay. Anyway, so I'm watching this TikTok on YouTube and the lady was talking about how wives get cheated on and they get cheated on because it was really a wife off. And it's become like the slogan for LendingTree, how they say like when banks compete, you win.
Break up with your banker and play the field at LendingTree. When banks compete, you win.
When women compete, men win. And they know this. And that's the reason why it doesn't really matter if you're light skin or if you're dark skin, because they will fuck you both. But if they can keep you diametrically opposed to each other, if they can tell you fuck shit, like, you know what I mean? I really like light skin, but you know, you not like other women because other women don't know how to submit. You know, white women, y'all understand how to take care of a man. Black women don't. Like, we are divided as women down into what your feet look like. I mean, it's too much competition, okay? There ain't no competition like the real competition, because the real competition is a real ass woman. Anyway, so my point is, I'm listening to an unmarried woman do a response to a married woman, and I'm going to put the video in here so I don't have to do a whole bunch of explaining what's going on.
A lot of y'all are only just good for the kinkiness and having somebody paint your face with their bodily fluid.
But who's really winning if the wife is still getting cheated on by the woman that he wants to do freaky things with? That's what doesn't matter. It don't make no sense to me. Like, he wants to marry a woman that he can cheat on with in peace. Y'all don't see that? Like, that's what this comes down to. But the wife is the only one that's getting cheated on. So, what? Now, I've never been married, but I truly, wholeheartedly like to believe that there are married couples out there who are having the time of their lives in their marital bed, in their marital bedroom. But this conversation, I truly, truly hope that this is just some TikTok stuff, because it's silly. Y'all don't want to satisfy your partner? Like, is that what this is about? Like, everybody just want to be better than somebody, but everybody in that situation losing. Like, what are we talking about? The husband don't want to be honest about his true sexual desires. The wife getting cheated on, and the side chick, maybe.
Even though I'm not fully sure I understand all the context for either one of the videos, the original one or the response, but you watch it and let me know what you got out of it, if it took you to the same place I went with it. So I felt like the first woman was putting out some information to side chicks about how they really don't have any value to married men, I'm guessing, other than their sexual value. So then she clapped back for whatever reason. I mean, is she with somebody's husband? I don't know. There was just not enough information, not enough context. And this is the reason why I, in my mind, can't watch TikTok, because I'm invested. I need to be on Facebook where you can tell me the whole entire story. You know, I need a YouTube video. I need like 20 minutes to make sure I got it straight. But my understanding of what she was saying was that ultimately, if a wife is not being sexually everything her husband needs, she's the only one that stands to lose, because she's the one that's actually getting cheated on. The man is getting what he wants with the side chick. The side chick is getting what she wants with the man, and the wife is the one that's being cheated on. I'm not going to try to decipher that. That's a fair enough assessment. Okay. But this was my response. I'm going to read it to you, and I'm going to respond to myself responding. Okay. Because I think I brought out some really good points of why, first of all, the whole response was ridiculous, but definitely why, as much as people think wives are losing in these situations, it's just a failure on our part as Black people to understand even the most basic tenets of marriage. And as I'm meeting a lot of other women, women my age, older, younger, who have never been married, and still, after all they've seen in the Black community of marriage, aspire to be married. I'm not saying don't. I still aspire to be married for the reason and function of what marriage is. But I think your reasoning for marriage changes a lot from the inside out. You know, it's like being a business owner or a parent. Lots of people are like, well, I read books. Well, I raised my cousins. I did this. Until you're on the inside of something looking out, your perspective is going to be limited at best. So my response to her was as follows. I said, I've been married twice, and it doesn't matter how hard you go. Nobody's doing that every day. Marriage is about the mundane. Marriage is about the daily practices that lead to perfection. Most people want to find the perfect person to marry and marry them in that perfect state where they will be cryogenically suspended in animation. But the truth of the matter is, real people need practice. And I know what people are going to say, because people make mistakes all day. Practice is not with nobody else, okay? I've only ever had two reasons why I would leave a marriage. One is for abandonment. The second is for adultery. As long as you're here and not cheating, we good. So everything else, though, is a practice. That's what they hold for better, worse, sickness, health, rich or poor thing was about. It was to make sure you had a person that wouldn't bail because of the season. So ain't nobody going to be doing that every single day. There are a lot of things both men and women do. And it's weird because men will call it out with women and say, well, as soon as I married her, she stopped dressing, she changed. She was nice when we was dating, but now she didn't change. But they don't see it on the other side. When it's us, we should have chose better. Like, we should have known perpetually what this man was going to do after we had a child with him. After we there's no way to physically see every person through every season. And if that's true with men, why can't that be true with women? Ah, I know why. Misogyny, male privilege, patriarchy. But I digress. So I said, nobody ever cares if women are sexually fulfilled in their marriage. Woo. And that was really the whole message. I could have finished right there. Because all this focus on men cheating as a means to find sexual gratification that they don't have in their marriages is really just weird. It's really weird because I feel like women, what are we doing out here that these men really feel like they're the prize sexually? Like, we know what really be going on inside these bedrooms. And baby, it don't be chandeliers and champagne every night. Mm-mm, no. So women have stuck by men that don't eat ass while he can't get it up. I mean, some of us are not getting the performance of a lifetime every night. We are laying beside somebody that rolled over and then rolled back. Because like I said, of women, can't nobody do that every day. A woman ain't going to be in high heels and serving you dinner every day. I mean, she has down days. She has flat days. She has days where she's going to be in some, she has days when she's going to be in some Crocs. Okay. She has Crocs days. She has hair bun days. We have nails broke days, okay? And that's the same with men. But men, y'all mechanism is totally different than ours. And y'all do not knock it out the park every day. Y'all do not make it fun for us to want to get on top of you or be rolled by you night after night after night after night. But, you know, a good wife, a good woman is going to prioritize the needs of her husband, but she's not a second class citizen to him. So if there's work that needs to be done to pull her into a more fulfilling place in those encounters, that's conversations y'all need to have. The same way I hear men telling women they should be willing to do anything, anything their man want them to do. I mean, filthy, okay? Well, I'm going to need you to keep that same energy. So we are there with men who can't even get it up some nights. Then he will go out and pop a pill with another woman that didn't have to pop a boil on his ass. Okay, we as women inspect bumps. What is this bump? Can you look at this? Can you pop this? Baby, he popping a pill and you popping a bump. Wives go through a lot of shit that side chickens don't see. And that's the purpose of why some men keep women on the side. And, you know, there's a lot of back and forth about whether or not the side chick is the better woman because she got the married man out of his relationship, or whether the wife was really the better woman, because I'll hear a lot of people say that, like, oh, he left his wife for this woman and da 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 da. Who knows? They both could be good women sometimes. And just because a woman is on the side doesn't necessarily mean that she's a slut or she's trash. And there is some belief to me, and men, y'all can chime in and tell me how wrong I am and burn your faces off in my comments. But I think a lot of times women are put on the side just simply for the anonymity of the man, simply because there are just things that that man doesn't want that woman to know about him so that he can continue to be her superhero. You know, as a matter of fact, if some men could take their wives back to being side chicks so that they could have the newness and the, you know, spontaneity of the relationship they had going into the marriage, they probably would. Because a lot of men will leave their wives, go with the new chick, then be calling them, you know, I miss you. You know, can I just see you? We don't even have to do nothing. And then they'll turn the wife into a side chick. I know. I've had to tell a couple of guys I was in relationships with that I am not getting ready to rent a room in a house I used to own, because, baby, they'll leave me and then try to turn me into a side chick. I'm like, well, and then we as women don't understand that concept, because we like, well, if you wanted to be with me, you could have just stayed. But that wasn't what they wanted. They didn't want to be with you. They wanted to be everything to you. And a lot of men don't feel like they can be with you and still be your everything because of what I'm about to talk about. Wives go through a lot of shit that side chickens don't see. And that's what men really want. The woman who has never stuck an enema in his ass. Okay. Yeah. Cause I done had to unblock some passages. Okay. We wives do things for the sake of our husbands. Everybody reduce that stuff down to sex. But when you really are in a trench with someone, when somebody's really sick, when you've had to put a catheter, when you've had to deal with someone who has a catheter, okay, when you've had to deal with someone who has a dialysis port, they want us fit, feminine, and friendly, but a lot of them don't take care of themselves, don't even have primary care physicians. Maybe you in for a treat. You in for a treat in a couple of years. That is the shit that makes a wife unsexy. Once a woman sees a man at his lowest, he wants the gaze of a woman that thinks he's a hero. Trust me, wives are the biggest freaks that a man met that he could still trust. And that's true. Okay, a lot of women are in that side spot coming for the wife and don't understand why they can't get him out the house. Baby, wives are freaks. And they may not be the biggest freak a man ever met, but they were freak enough for him to still be able to trust them. Because, like, yeah, a man want all that. But the more experience you're showing him that he has, and don't jump down my throat, ladies, because I already did my video on body count and told y'all to stop letting people make you feel some type of way for body count, because your body count is whatever his body count is multiplied by 3, simply because you are the multiplier. So whatever type of body count he's bringing to you is more important than your body count. Trust and believe, because he's the one making the deposit, not the other way around. I digress. I said, wives are disgusting, and they are, maybe in more ways than one, because like I already told you what we was doing. But if a man wants a woman that is untainted by him, a woman who has never seen him fail, he gets a side chicken. The wife can suck that man until her forehead caves in, but it doesn't give him his dignity back. Baby, you can suck that man like a McDonald's milkshake every night, every time he get home. You can pull up to his job on his lunch break to suck him off. It will not give him what a woman who's never seen him at his lowest gives him. And I know this is kind of like gross, but some men transmute that type of adoration to daughters, like when they have daughters or mothers that worship them like that. You can see some triangulation with that type of situation, because they want a woman who has never had to inspect a boil that's on the back of their ass. Like, they just, it's understandable. You know, we as women have lots of vulnerable spaces and time. It's a little bit different because for a lot of us, our men aren't there. They don't have the same empathy in those spaces and times with us. So we never feel as low in front of them as they feel to us, because even when we're at our lowest, we're still going to get up and cook. We're still going to get up and go to the grocery store. We're still going to be like, well, I can go ahead and take care of the baby tonight. You help me out. We're so grateful. We're just naturally reciprocators because we're the multiplier. Because women are the only one in the union who are able to actually create anything, who can actually create out of their own flesh. It's the woman that makes the two one flesh. So we naturally are more deeply able to feel the empathy, the wounds of our men than they do with us. Now, a man who's in tune with his role, a man whose goal is to make it to the end with his wife, who set a goal on his marriage, who doesn't feel like the goal for his marriage was back at getting married and now he just on hiatus until it ends. The men who actually set the goal out past marrying the woman and actually set the goal to either burying that woman, you know, laying his life all the way down to make sure he could carry her all the way to a grave, or laying his life all the way down to make sure that she was taken care of in his death. Like a man who has it planned that far out, you know, he's not going to feel the same way. He's going to have a kindredness with his wife because he has set his intention on that. But more often than not, and I can say this because I've been inside of a lot of marriages, and when you're married, you have married friends as well. You know, you're a part of marriage groups. Just a lot of things that single people don't necessarily put themselves into those situations until after they get married. And so, baby, I just had in groups of women crying about their husbands lacking empathy. I mean, large groups of lots of women. So this is not an atypical experience. And men love to argue with you about facts. 70% of women file for divorce, but they can't negate your lived experience. People can throw statistics and facts at you all day, but if your lived experience says something else, then baby, you can crunch them facts up and put them up in your ass, because that's what you're living life for, is to have some experiences that are going to teach you something at some point, I'm thinking. Anyway, a married man has to be humble and selfless to ride out the ups and downs of a marriage and please one woman. It's a lot harder to please one woman than many women. As a matter of fact, the more you can get women triangulated against each other, the better. The better. Some guy said it this way: women want men that other women want. I think that's it. I think that was right. If he's a narcissist, which a lot of men are. Narcissism is a product of privilege. And that's the reason why we see so many more male narcissists than women. That's not to say that there are not female narcissists. And I would dare to say there is a growing number of more and more female narcissists simply because women are beginning to have a lot of the privilege that men have. Dating apps, social media has given women a whole lot more privilege than it's given to men. Men are thirst trapping all over women's social media and dating app platforms more than women are men, even though some of these women are, woo, desperate housewives. I mean, Jesus. But for the most part, men being more of the pursuers than women are means that they're going to be in those spaces, giving women a lot more privilege and building entitlement in women. So there are a lot of female narcissists, and some men need to get hip to that and stop being out here broken and wounded by somebody who lacked empathy and thinking that they lack empathy because they're a woman. They lack empathy because they're entitled. Grow the fuck up. It is not all women. It's just the ones you choose. And you choose ones that are privileged and entitled because you like it. Then you tell women they shouldn't want to be privileged and entitled because of the ones you chose. You told us to choose better. Choose better. Get a therapist. If he's a narcissist who expects the relationship to revolve around him, which goes back to patriarchy, because this is how most women who want to get married are programmed.
Religion is what gives you your sexism. Religion today in America totally disrespects women and femininity. This goes into our society. Our whole education becomes masculine. And what happens is you have God as a man. Nothing to do with women. God only has sons, no daughters. He only inspires men to write holy books that are about men. This is irrational thinking. And if you, for all the people out there that study psychology, you know that masculinity represents the analytical and femininity represents the creative. If you have no feminine respect in your society, you lack creative thinkers.
Please the man, please the man, please the man, please the man. Then most men go into marriages out of those types of relationships with women, not knowing how to please a woman because he's never had to. Because when banks compete, you win. When women are competing for you as a scarce resource, and men will always be that because they die earlier, they're incarcerated at a larger rate than women are. You know, there's a lot more competition for men than there is for women, which is why the concept of polygamy was initially brought into some of these Abrahamic cultures. People love to act like polygamy is this thing that's just supposed to be the common right of every man because he has a penis. No, his job is to take care of women and children who ordinarily wouldn't have been taken care of because there was no social services, because the state wasn't going to come and collect child support from a father who had abandoned his family. So polygamy was seen as a way to take care of some of these unmarried women. And that was even only because they didn't have the rights of men to be able to own property, have jobs. You know, now that we can do that, I mean, we don't need polygamy, you psychos. Anyway, so I said a narcissist who expects the relationship to revolve around him will cheat every time, every time, at every opportunity, baby. Indiscriminately make a baby. It just does not matter. And that's why we're seeing what we're seeing, because some people, like at work with the person you work with, you would put your job in jeopardy. Baby, yes. He's going to cheat every time, then come home to his wife and ask his wife to pick an ingrown hair out of his chin. People need to grow up, and single people need to stop speaking on marriages. A lot of women will feel like a woman's space is being displaced by this outside woman. But a lot of times a wife's place is being secured by the worship of that outside woman. He's coming back home in a soft, more vulnerable place, having been puffed up as a hero to his wife. That's why a lot of people be like, why she don't leave? I know he must have been treating her bad. Sometimes, yes. But sometimes, no. Sometimes men are treating their wives better when they're cheating because they're guilty. They're coming home and bringing flowers after years of not bringing flowers. She's sitting there thinking to herself like, okay, are things good with us? Like, what? Because men really have to have worship in the wind of their sails to feel like men. At least men who are codependent and don't have and lack self-esteem do. But even the strongest man, even the greatest man, needs to feel like a hero to his woman and his children. If he's ever in a place where he doesn't feel like he's going to be the hero in the situation, you're going to see him disengage from that relationship, whether it be a relationship with a child or a relationship with a woman, because men are hardwired to protect and to provide. So if they don't feel in that space like those men, they will seek that somewhere else. But I just wanted to come on here and kind of give a little bit of perspective to a lot of women who think that they want to get into marriages. A lot of women do well in marriages and do better than men do because they just naturally are worshipers. When you go to these churches, there's nothing but women inside of them, and there's nothing but women inside of them because women are naturally wired for worship. And your worship of God is never contingent on his performance. Because trust me, some of y'all are super unhappy and you're still praying, still hoping, wishing, praying, and believing. And you have to, if you want to be a wife, have that same mentality about how you're going to approach your relationship with your man. Because he's going to be up sometimes, down sometimes, fail sometimes, lose jobs, be rich sometimes, poor other times, and make some dumb ass fucking decisions. As a matter of fact, as a wife, you are there to be his wisdom. So he gonna make a lot of dumb, stupid ass, fucked up decisions in the beginning of y'all marriage, because that was exactly what a man needed a wife for. A wife was created to be a helpmeet. How you gonna help somebody meet the responsibility of God that don't need no help?
Ever embarrassed they wife? She told you not to do that shit. She told you he's gonna fuck the money up.
It ain't no perfect men out there, but that don't mean you got to put up with some cheating, though. But the note that I have from this whole entire video, from chasing these rabbits all around this tree for half an hour, is for side chicks. Because I know there are a lot of side chickens, as I call them, think they're better women than wives. But if you were a better woman than a wife, you'd be a wife. Stop letting these men bait you into competition with their wives. Their wives know who they are. They done stuck enemas in these niggas. They done slept in hospital chairs beside these men. They are the homeowners in the house that you rent. They have made a deeper investment. They stand to lose something that you can't understand, which is the reason why for you to tear down a wall means nothing. The homeowner got to come back in and fix it, even just to sell it. These men are not made whole by anything that you do. Even if, like in the Kevin Hunter, is that Wendy Williams' husband name? Who cares? Even in a place where they will replace a wife with a side chick, they're replacing a wife with a side chick, expecting a side chick to do what wives do. And because that side chick was only put there to be a worshiper and not a partner, more often than not, they're subordinate to these men and they can't help them and they can't build them up. And we're watching a lot of men get women that aren't learning in their marriage with them how to be the same. That's what y'all are supposed to be. The two are supposed to become one. That means that if you're doing a business negotiation and you can't make it that day and you have to send your wife on your behalf, you know that she's going to be the one that's like, no, the paper says this. He's expecting this price for these units. So when the mechanic tries to say, well, no, there's also the rubric that needs to be fixed, she's going to say, well, let me call my husband because he prepared me to pay this much, and this wasn't what you said to him. They got to be shrewd. They got to bring the same authority as that man, because they're Mrs. Robert Maurice Johnson or whatever. I was pulling up some names of some people I actually dated, and I didn't want them to think I was talking about them. But my point is, because you're the Mrs. of that particular entity, you should bring the same authority to a situation. These men say they want women that'll submit to them and do whatever it is that they're telling them to do until they get into a hospital. and a doctor is telling these women, like, well, we're going to have to take off his foot. You want the type of woman that's going to push back and say, have we done everything else that can be done? I looked online and did some research, and that medication that you put him on might be the reason why he's losing blood flow in that foot. Oh, then they want a smart woman. Then they want a shrewd woman. When y'all are looking at how you can build for the next level of your life, and you're the type of woman that says, well, we do have two areas in our budget where we can pull a little bit of money out and begin to put it in another account. Let's go ahead and turn off the streaming services. Let's go ahead and make some changes. I think I can cook a few more nights a week, and let's go ahead and make that change. Based on that, we'll be able to save about $500 a month. And I think that's going to be the thing that does it. You want the type of woman that can help you psychos. And side chickens are not that. So side chickens, don't get lost in the sauce. Don't get lost in the sauce. Wives are wives for a reason. And don't ever let a man put you in that place. Don't ever let a man turn you into a tenant, a squatter, and a renter in another woman's house. Because he will never fully respect you the way he respected her, even if he make you a wife. You'll be an underwife. You'll be an understudy. Bitch, you understudy. That's what you are. And like I said, I've been a married woman that has had my own ex-wife try to turn me into a side chick. And baby, the answer was no. No. Be bigger than that and better than that, because you're not in competition with these women. And wives, stop thinking that you're better than other women just because you got that nigga. You got that nigga's burdens. Okay? He came to lay his burdens down. And that's why he chose you over this woman. Because he knows she could potentially get away, but he expected you to stay. So we just got to stop competing with each other as women and really be looking at how we can choose good partners and build healthy relationships with those good partners, and completely trash and get rid of trash men who are trash partners. Because whether they're being trash to us or to her or to somebody else, that is indicative of them being trash men, not you being a good woman. Okay? A good woman chooses a good man, and she puts herself in a position to win. Y'all are putting yourselves in positions to be eternal girlfriends, to be forever a fiance. And that is why we're in the situation that we're in. They can gaslight us all they want to and be like, y'all women need to, y'all don't know how to be y'all masculine and y'all this and y'all that. And when banks compete, you win.
When banks compete, you win.
Baby, when women compete, now these men are out here turning into narcissistic, psychopathic monsters that nobody can tolerate. That's why they at home with their mama, because she the only one that can deal. She the only one that can deal with the monster that she created. So women, don't be an extension of that. Don't be an extension of a man's mother. Be a man's partner. And the only reason why we are in these marriages and these relationships with men is for the purpose of learning how to be like them. No man wants to diminish you. If he's in a marriage with you, his goal should be to bring you up to his equal, to make sure no one else in the world can look at you as just a woman. Because you are someone's wife, because you have the power and authority of the name of a man behind you. It's supposed to be your protection, not your oppression. If you see what I see and you feel how I feel.
But if you see what I see, if you feel as I feel, and if you would seek as I seek.
Go ahead and drop that fire. Headphones emoji in the comments. Ladies, if you have been married and you have some advice for these women that's out here getting lured into a trap, into a snare with these married men, please help me out. Okay, please, sisters, help me out in these comments. Okay, because I am in charge of the girls. That's what I came here to do. But until the next transmission, baby, you know what to do. Go ahead and clock out for me. You are dismissed.
No, Sister Terry, if it's over your head, jump off the live, baby.